Good evening, everyone. My name is Saad Alaradi. Today I will present to you about coronavirus, the COVID-19, the new virus or the new epidemic management plan and RT management plan, and to be specific. This presentation was prepared by myself and two of my colleagues, Badr Admawi and Mohamed Al-Adegi. First, I will talk about what is COVID-19. COVID-19 is or coronavirus 2019 is a new strain of coronaviruses. This family is very big family, from the common cold up to very serious diseases as of COVID-19. Now this virus or COVID-19 was first administered in Wuhan in 2019. In terms of symptoms of coronavirus disease, the reported illness has only few studies since it's a new disease, but the symptoms can range from a mild symptom up to a severe symptoms depending on the virus or the patient clinical presentation. The virus has an incubation period from 2 days up to 14 days. Symptoms can range from fever, high fever, cough, and shortness of breath. Now, patient can present with abdominal symptoms, but as RTs, we are more concerned about the respiratory symptoms and how to manage the respiratory symptoms. For the risk factors, in terms of risk factors, who are at more at risk of getting COVID-19? COPD patients. Now, why COPD patients have more risk of getting the new virus? Why COPD patients have more risk of getting COVID-19? COPD patients have more risk to get COVID-19 because they have low respiratory immunity. They are more at risk of getting any respiratory infection. Now, for the respiratory infections from COVID-19 or other infections. Now, smoking. Smokers have more capability of getting COVID-19 than normal people, because smokers frequently keep touching their face to smoke, and this is a route of a transmission for COVID-19. On the other hand, also smoking decreases the respiratory immunity, making the patient at more risk of getting COVID-19. We will start talking about the RT side of COVID-19. What does the RT need to prepare from equipment, and what are the procedures that the RT should do for COVID-19 patients? For the RT equipment, we should always have the oropharyngeal airway or Goodall's airway, from child sizes to up to adult sizes. We should prepare all this equipment depending on the case. Is he a child or an adult? For the oropharyngeal airway, it should be prepared because the patient may need to open his airway in terms of airway management. The other equipment that we should have is the carbon dioxide detector, and we should also prepare the endotracheal tube with or without cuff, depending on the patient. If we have neonate or pediatric patient, most likely they will have uncuffed EDT, and for adults we'll have cuffed EDT. Laryngeal mask. Now, a laryngeal mask, we need to prepare the appropriate size for the patient, and we need to also check in terms of EDT or laryngeal mask. We need to check the cuff, is there a leak, and we need to check if the tube is good to... we should also prepare the laryngoscope. Now, per se, every patient who has a disease that may progress like the disease or the COVID-19, patient may need intubation. That's why we need to prepare the laryngoscope. For the other equipments, now, patients may not need the intubation, but you will definitely need an IV mask or an IV non-invasive ventilation. So we should prepare the NIV mask, whether it was full face mask or only nasal mask or oral mask. Ventilators. We need to have non-invasive ventilator, invasive ventilator, and transport ventilator, depending on where is the patient and what does he need. Oxygen tube extensions and devices. We need to prepare the oxygen devices and the oxygen extensions and the flow meters, depending on what we will put the patient on, whether it was nasal cannula. or simple face mask or non-breathing mask or even Venturi mask. Resuscitators. Now, in some studies, they say that resuscitators should not be used with COVID-19 patients because it's an aerosol-generating procedure. But we may need the resuscitator in emergency cases. For example, if we have the ventilator and the ventilator broke down, or there is a problem with our ventilator, or a problem with our circuit, we need to unplug the patient until we get a new ventilator. Set of stainless steel depressors or blades for the for our laryngoscope, whether it was Miller type or Macintosh type. The tracheal tube introducer, the bougie or the stylet. We need to prepare the bougie and prepare the stylet to be prepared for any emergency. In terms of humidifiers, we need to prepare the patient ventilator circuit along with HME. Now, talking about the management, as an RT for COVID-19 patient, what should I do? Or what is my role in COVID-19 management plan? My role as an RT is oxygen therapy, prone positioning, respiratory medication administration, whether it was an MDI, a DPI, or an nebulization, non-invasive ventilation, intubation and invasive ventilation, weaning from ventilator, and eventually extubation. In terms of oxygen therapy, now, in oxygen therapy, we need to sort the patients as an adult or a child, adult or pediatric. Now, in terms of adults, adults with emergency signs or with COVID-19 signs should be first administered oxygen therapy because they will per se have hypoxia. Now, what should I use from oxygen devices? Oxygen device should be used according to what the patient tolerate. If the patient, our targeted SpO2. Our targeted SpO2 should be above 94 or above 90 in severe cases. Now, let's say we have a patient on simple face mask, 5 liters, and he is maintaining his saturation. This is good. If the patient cannot maintain his saturation, I need to change my plan or my oxygen therapy plan. Now, let's say we have a pregnant woman with COVID-19. Now, pregnant woman should have saturation above 90. 90 is acceptable for pregnant women. And non-pregnant adults, whether it was female or male, we should maintain the saturation between 92 to 95, if possible. Now for children, children with emergency cases are managed with oxygen therapy, but their targeted SpO2 should be between above or equal to 90. So 90 is acceptable in children. Now respiratory failure and sepsis and respiratory failure and sepsis should be taken in consideration since all the studies have showed that respiratory failure and sepsis are the most common end result of COVID-19 in terms of respiratory. Respiratory medication administration. Now, as an RT, we administer respiratory medication, whether it was MDI, DPI, or nebulization. In COVID-19 patients, they will also get some respiratory medications, but what why they are different from other patients. They are different because nebulization is not recommended in their cases because the nebulizers could generate aerosol. Generating aerosol can make the disease transmit as airborne. So we should limit our use to MDI as much as possible in these patients. If we have to use the nebulizer, we should be in a negative pressure room, or the room should have negative pressure room or HEPA filter. Now, what are the types of medications that COVID-19 patients may need? First, they might need bronchodilators. Bronchodilators are very important in managing respiratory diseases. The second drug could be antibiotics. Antibiotics for the infections that they may have since they have low respiratory immunity. Now, in terms of steroids are not recommended for these patients, for COVID-19 patients. We can administer also diuretics for this patient, it is recommended. Non-invasive ventilation. Now, in patients with the COVID-19 who are going to hypoxic respiratory failure, we should administer non-invasive ventilation. Now, for non-invasive ventilation or high flow nasal oxygen, can be administered, but it is not highly recommended because it's an aerosol generating procedure. If we must use high flow nasal oxygen or non-invasive ventilation, we should take in consideration that it should be a 1 hour or 2 hour trial. If the patient maintained and got better after this 1 to 2 hour trial, then we can say that this is beneficial and we can keep the patient and start weaning. If after this trial the patient is not improving, the patient presentation is the same or getting worse, we should stop this treatment and progress to the second step. Now, in terms of non-invasive settings, non-invasive is not highly recommended only in hypoxic expiratory failure, as I was saying. For the settings, it is recommended to put him on CPAP. CPAP settings should be according to the patient, the patient's ABG, the CO2, the BaO2. These are the what determines our settings or initial settings. But the initial mode is CPAP. Now, if the CPAP is not working for this patient, we should go. They will eventually fall in respiratory failure, hypoxic respiratory failure, and then end result total respiratory failure. So the next step is intubation and invasive ventilation. Now, studies suggested that early intubation for these patients is highly beneficial. It has more than one benefit. That's why the non-invasive and the high flow oxygen trial is supposed to be 1 to 2 hours, because we don't want to delay the intubation. Now, early intubation, what are the benefits of early intubation? First benefit, prevent the spread of infection, since it's not an aerosol generating procedure. The second one is decrease the risk of disease progression, since the patient will, the end result, he will respiratory failure and respiratory distress syndrome. The procedure. What is the role of the RT in this procedure? Now, in this procedure should be done smoothly. So the RT need to prepare all the equipment, even the equipment that might not be used. He need to prepare the ETT, all sizes of ETT. If the patient is an adult, he should prepare from 6 up to 8.5 in the sizes. He need to prepare the stylet, the bougie, the CO2 detector, the ambu bag. He need to prepare every equipment, even if there is a chance of not using this equipment. Why? Because we need to limit going in and out of the patient room to limit the transmission of COVID-19 or of the virus. Now, after the intubation, the patient should not be placed on ambu bag, because it is an aerosol-generating procedure. A generating procedure, as we all know, can help in transmitting the patient and transmitting the disease and make it airborne. So we should immediately, after the intubation, place the patient on the mechanical ventilator, start ventilation, and then confirm the tube place with X-ray or with stethoscope. Now, in terms of invasive ventilation, now intubated COVID-19 patient, as studies recommended, are ventilated with ARDS protocol, which means high RR and low tidal volume. The recommended settings. Now, first, the mood. What is the recommended mood for COVID-19 patient? Now, as studies showed, the most beneficial mood for this patient is APRV, airway pressure release ventilation. Now, if in the hospital we don't have the APRV, we can all use the pressure control or the PRVC. In terms of settings, the FiO2 should be initially 80 to 100. The respiratory rate should be 16 to 25. The tidal volume, 4 to 6 ml per kg. In terms of the PEEP, it should be 8 to 12 centimeters of water. Now, in mechanical ventilator, we should use the lung protective strategies as the studies recommend. Now, permissive hypercapnia can be used with these patients since they are ARDS patients. So we will have high CO2, low oxygen. So we can use the permissive hypercapnia if needed. Now, in terms of humidifiers or humidification in the mechanical ventilator, we can use the HME or the heated wire. In terms of weaning, now the patient is ventilated, the patient is getting better, he is improving, and we want to start weaning the patient off ventilator. Weaning COVID-19 patients is not different from weaning any other patient. We should start by weaning the PEEP until it reaches 5. If the patient is tolerating PEEP 5, we should then go to weaning FiO2. Weaning FiO2 up to be less than 40%, 40%, keeping the SpO2 more than 92 or more than 90. Then we start giving the patient SBT, spontaneous breathing trials. Now, if the patient is tolerating the spontaneous breathing trials, we can then wean the patient and extubate him. If the patient is not tolerating the spontaneous breathing trial, we should keep him on mechanical ventilator until he gets better. In terms of extubation, now extubating a COVID-19 patient is not different from extubating any other patient, except in some points. The first point, we should only suction these patients with closed suction system. Now we all know that before extubation, we should suction the patient airway. Now in COVID-19 patient, we should not suction them with open suction. We should only suction with closed system suction catheters. Why? Because these patients, because suction is an aerosol generating procedure. So open suction should not be used with this patient. The second point, this patient should not be extubated to non-invasive ventilation, because non-invasive ventilation is aerosol generating procedure. So when we extubate this patient, they should be placed on oxygen device or room air, and room air is better because the oxygen is also an aerosol generating procedure, but we cannot extubate the patient immediately to room air except in rare cases. After extubation, we should closely monitor the patient's ABG and the patient's chest x-ray for improvement. ABG. What is the ABG that I should expect from a COVID-19 patient? Now, normally, ABG results, BH will be between 7.35 to 7.45. The BaO2 will be between 75 and 100. The CO2 will be 35 to 45. BCO2 will be 35 to 45. And the bicarb will be between 22 to 26. Now, in COVID-19 patients, the BH will be on the acidotic side, so less than 7.35, and the BaO2 will be will reveal hypoxemia, so it will be less than 70. The CO2 will reveal hypercapnia, so it will be more than 45, and the bicarb will be more than 26 to compensate for high CO2 for the respiratory acidosis. So in COVID-19 patients, it's safely to say that they will have respiratory acidosis with hypoxemia. For the chest x-ray, now for this chest x-ray, this is a real COVID-19 patient for first day of admission and second day of admission. Now in the first day of admission, we can see clearly the infiltrate on the bilateral infiltrate on both sides of the lung with ground glass appearance. Now this x-ray is a typical COVID-19 patient x-ray. Ground glass appearance, bilateral infiltrate. Now this patient, after a few hours, he was intubated, and in the second day, another x-ray was taken. Now, on the second day of patient admission, after intubation, you can see clearly the ATT here. The patient has increased infiltrate bilaterally. This is totally white lung, and the patient is going to ARDS picture. Now, we want to prevent this ARDS picture. That is why we are ventilating this patient on ARDS protocol. And lung protective protocols to prevent the patient from being in ARDS picture. Now, some important equation the RT should always remember in dealing with COVID-19 patient. The RSBI, the rapid shallow breathing index for extubation. The rapid shallow breathing index will be respiratory rate over the tidal volume. And now, this equation is important. The rapid shallow breathing index is important in terms of extubating the patient. It is one of the signs that shows if the patient will have successful extubation or not. For the PF ratio, the RT should always remember the PF ratio equation, which is the BaO2 over the FiO2. This equation is important since we are dealing with patients that might fall into ARDS picture. Then we need to know the PF ratio to know the severity of the disease. And we should always remember the ideal body weight equation. Ideal body weight equation is important to know how much tidal volume we should give the patient, since we are ventilating them at low tidal volume, 46 ml per kg. Now for male, the equation is 50 plus 0.9 multiplied by the height in centimeters minus 52.4. Now for the females, it is 45.5 For female, it is 45.5 plus 0.91 multiplied by height in centimeters minus 52.4. These are the most important equations that the RT should always remember in dealing with COVID-19 patient. At the end, thank you for listening, and I hope you get the benefit that we want you to get. And always remember to stay safe, help all your patients, but always remember to protect yourself first. Thank you.